Go.
Hi there. This is our sail bag. It houses our mainsail, which is really the workhorse of our whole sail system.
Hey babe.
Hi.
I was thinking, since we're kind of settled here in the Rio for a little while.
Oh, here we go.
That we could show everybody the boat.
Kind of give them a tour.
Yeah.
That's a good idea. We've been talking about doing that.
But
there's always a but.
This boat is doity. Doesn't look bad.
What?
Yeah, we can't be inviting people over and showing the boat in this condition.
Okay.
So
better get to cleaning then. That means I gotta quit. Okay.
Well, clean up your mess.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's go. Yeah, I'm gonna need some music for this. There we go.
Babe!
What?
Get back to work!
Oh god, okay. It's hot.
Welcome to our home. All right, where do we begin?
What kind of boat?
Yeah, let's say what kind of boat she is.
Okay, so what we bought is a Fontaine Pajot owner's version. She's a 2014 and it's the Evolution Maestro version, meaning that the starboard cabin is all the owner's side with a full head, and we don't have any other cabins or guests on that side. We bought her in, I would say,
better than perfect condition.
Yeah, absolutely. Better than new condition, yeah. Because the owner worked out all the kinks.
Yeah, the 2014, it's a French made boat, and they are kind of top of the line in their class.
Absolutely.
With the production of catamarans.
Yep.
So far, we have sailed her since we bought her about 3,000 nautical miles. Yes. And we put about 300 hours on the motor.
Yeah, that's about it.
So we have two, Warren will show you in a little bit, but two Volvo Penta,
yep.
30 horsepower engines.
That's correct.
And we've learned a lot about the boat and how she runs, what she prefers as far as sail on port tack or starboard tack.
Yeah, you're learning.
It's amazing. We have multiple sails, yep. A couple that came standard with the boat, obviously. And
the main and the jib.
Main and the jib. We bought a
parasailer, which is fantastic. Downwind sail. Another downwind sail we just got in Florida was the asymmetrical spinnaker. Yep. And the boat came with a light wind jib. It's a bigger version of a jib in the front sail, which is called a jennaker.
Yeah.
So we have those three sails. We actually also have a very small storm sail in emergency conditions. We haven't had to use it. In fact, I don't think it's ever been used.
No, I don't
cross
think we, yeah, we tried to pull it out one day when we had zero wind.
Yeah, just to know how to put it up.
Yeah, but yeah, we're really getting to know the boat and how to live together in small quarters.
Yeah.
All the time, 24/7.
Okay.
I think we should just get on with it and show them around.
All right, let's go.
This is like take 32, day 3.
All right, guys, I'm gonna take you through the outside and then I'm gonna turn it over to Eric to finish up by taking you through the inside. Catamarans have a great amount of space compared to their monohull brethren. It's probably one of the main reasons why we decided to go with the catamaran. Out of all of the boats that we toured, which was a lot, they seem to be the best organized and the most attractive layouts of all the boats. The boat came with one solar panel set. The owner installed a second set above me here, and I installed a third back in November and December in Martinique. It's more than enough to cover the microwave, the fridge, freezer, instruments, and all of our electrical needs. This frame here is for the solar panel set that the owner installed. It also houses our fishing gear and spear fishing gear. It also was a perfect platform for me to build a table here, which really is such a great dive platform. It's a great place to have sundowners and watch sunsets. And it is a perfect place for us to mount our scuba tanks. So this is basically our outside dining area and really where we lounge most of the time. The original owners who we bought the boat from were Australian, and bless their heart, they went to the hard work of importing an Australian barbecue grill, because you know the Aussies, how they're known for their barbecues. This is serious business here. As Erica mentioned before, we have two Volvo Pentas. It's real reliable motors. The engine compartments are quite sizable. They're plenty for me to get in and have access all the way around the motor. That definitely does not happen always in sailboats, but this one does. So this is the engine compartment. What else do we got? Let's see. Let's move around the side here up to the helm station. Welcome to the helm station. In my opinion, the best seat in the house. This is such a great setup and really well thought out for a small crew, where all of the controls lead back to this station, where a lot of other boats have some of the winches at the mast, which means that you have to go to the mast to be able to either reef or to drop the sails. We don't. Everything comes back here. All our lines lead back to here, which keep us in a safe location. The boat has pretty standard equipment here. We have Garmin everything, Garmin compass and autopilot, the GPS speed, water speed, and depth gauge here. And on the bottom is the wind indicator, the direction, and the speed. For a chart plotter, we have at the helm station a Garmin, and our iPod we have Navionics for at the helm station. Moving on. All right, we're at the bow of the boat, and up here we have probably the second best seat in the house, the beanbag chair. This catamaran sailboat is a conventional sailboat with it only has one mast. It really simplifies things for new sailors like us. But this is the main mast here, and this is the main sail. This is really the workhorse sail that we've got, and it's gonna be the first one we put up and first one we take down. The jib is up front, and it's much easier to roll in and out. So this one's really our workhorse though. This is what we call our chain locker. This will house the chain, our anchor, our spare anchors, which are in the back, and any spare ropes, chains, lines that we may have. And unplugged right now, but this is the heart of our pre-filter. It filters all the rainwater that we collect before going into the holding tank, so there's no sediment or anything getting into the holding tank. All right, so when we moved onto the boat, we wanted to live off the sea, and part of that was collecting our own rainwater. So this boat was a prime candidate for, actually it was very easy to set up a system that would collect rainwater, because everything from the roof really drains to three main locations. So this whole side would just drip off of here. So I set up this tube that collected all of this water and we put it into this tank. Then from this tank, I dump into the front holding tank. Let's show you. The original owners of this boat installed a pretty good water maker that does 65 liters an hour, which means that it would take about 10 hours to fill our water tanks. A good rainstorm would take about half that time. So I opted to start collecting and filtering the rainwater for this boat. So what I've done on the boat is I collect the water at the mast with a funnel that goes to a water pump in the chain locker that's activated by a float switch, then runs through a pre-filter before dumping the water into the holding tank, because we don't want any particulates ending up in there. So that's our pre-filter. Then that water is perfectly good to shower and do dishes with. The water that we drink goes through a Brita filter that's mounted under the sink, and voila.
All right, guys, that does it. I'm gonna pass you on to Erica to show you the inside.
Let go.
Come on in. Okay, so this is our home, and we call this the galley, where we have a full kitchen. Honestly, I've never been more comfortable on a boat with a full kitchen. We've got our stove, which is fueled by propane, as well as the oven. And we have a microwave, which we don't use all that often, honestly, because it does take a lot of our power up. We have three faucets here in the sink. This one here is our salt water, which we do most of our just regular rinsing. Fresh water, and then Warren installed this one with the Brita filter from our rainwater collection for drinking water. There is plenty of storage, to say the least, in the kitchen. We've got all our plates and our dishes, pots and pans, more storage. Warren installed a nice cutting board. It used to be this trash, and you could put about this much trash in there, which I didn't like at all, so Warren did that. And we have our Tupperware here with some dish rags. Then, kitchen, we have a two-drawer refrigeration system, basically, like this. Pretty swanky. And a freezer. So we've got ice and frozen fish when we get them. And what else? Champagne. Duh. And now, moving on to the dining room slash living room area, where we hang out and chill most of our days. And moving on from this side of the boat to this side of the boat, we have our nav station. Here at the nav station, this is pretty simplified for the most part. We have our chart plotter by Garmin, of course, and our battery monitor, and then all the gauges for fuel and water, and basically all of the switches here is for navigation, lights, pumps, so on and so forth. And then we have our sound system, which bumps pretty good, you know? Now let's take you to the sleeping quarters of the boat. Come on down. So we would call this the starboard cabin, master's cabin. That's why they call this the evolution version. So we got our full bed. It's a twin queen, not full queen for the most part. Really comfortable. We love it. And we got storage down here again, mine drawer, his drawer. Even underneath our carpet, all of the bilge space we use for storage. We also have plenty of closet space. I took the two-door system. Warren took the one. And we have plenty of room for my entire wardrobe, which I do need to downsize yet again. And Warren is very minimalist. Ta-da! But he keeps our sheets in here too. Over here, it's more storage. We keep our books, a lot of the GoPro and film gear, drone stuff. Warren has some more tools that he keeps drier out of the humidity in here. Right now, it's clean. Most of the time, it's just my clothes. But now, let's go to the front or the bow of the boat to the bathroom. The master bathroom is pretty spacious, actually. Here we have a full standing shower. Here, there is a pump, so whenever we are washing and everything, the water will drain down here, and it pumps directly back into the water. Up front is Warren's garage. It's downsized from what it was back home, but it'll do. We have all of our spare ropes, spare parts, and all these tools. There are toilet system on both sides. I'll show you the other one later. This one is a 1-2 button system, where one is pumping in salt water from the ocean to fill the toilet, and then you push 2, and it's directly into the ocean. We also have a holding tank, so when we're in anchorages or really pretty water and people are swimming in the water, or a marina, we close that up before we try to use the marina toilet. So that does it for the master side on starboard. So now let's head on over to the opposite side on port and check out the other two cabins. Okay, now we are on the port side cabin, and this is the aft cabin, or the back of the boat. And we have another twin queen bed. This is where most of our guests stay. They've got plenty of room, storage, closet space, pretty cozy. We like to have our guests feel at home. Okay, excuse me, we gotta get through. There's plenty of room. All right, now we have another cabin on the front of the boat, or the, help me out here.
Bow
of the boat, which we mostly use for storage unless we have a full house. So this bed is a little bit smaller than the other two beds. It's a little tapered on the end. Two people can sleep comfortably, one's probably better. That front locker over there, we can access either through here or the top of the boat, and it's our sail locker where we have all of our sails. And underneath, we stock up and provision plenty every time we stop somewhere, mostly because not sure when we're gonna find another grocery, even though every place we've been has been pretty decent. So these two cabins share one bathroom or one head, and it is a full shower and toilet. Excuse me, going in here. And so the same toilets, the 1 and 2 button electric pump, salt water and flushing out. And then the shower's just on this side here. We really hope you enjoyed that tour. It's been a lot of fun kind of showing you around the boat so you can kind of get a better idea of how we live for the last 9 months.
I don't know
how long we've been living out here. Anyways, if you have any questions or if there's anything that we skipped over that you are very curious about, just leave us a comment and we will get back to you and share those details later.
Absolutely. We answer every message you guys send us, and we love getting them too. We're going to put out a video next week on how we afford this lifestyle, how we bought the boat, how we afford to travel around the world on a boat, and we'll go into any kind of specifics on that. This one, we just wanted to give you an overview of this boat, maybe a catamaran, and maybe even you got some information on the specific Fontaine Pajot, which has been a fantastic boat for us.
Love this boat. We're beyond grateful for finding this boat, and the timing and everything, how we've moved on to it overall. So.
Yeah, it has been an amazing journey so far. The universe has really come together on this one for sure.
We are very blessed to have this boat and keep us afloat.
Yep. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and let us know if there's anything else we can do. That didn't work.
Bye!
Right here we have one of our 3 solar panels that keep our batteries filled all day long.
Go.
Hello. This is our main mast.
Okay, that's good. Wait a second. What?
Hello. Here's our mainsail.
You did it again. Be serious.